Hi everyone, welcome to this video on how to get started with the React Tooltip component. The React Tooltip component is a pop-up that shows information or a message when users hover, click, focus on, or touch an image, button, anchor tag, and more. The tooltip can show text, images, hyperlinks, or custom templates. In this video, you will see how to add the tooltip component to a React application. You will also see how to change its position, enable sticky mode, and render tooltip content using an HTML template. Before proceeding, ensure you have installed the latest versions of Node.js and React. First, I open Visual Studio Code and create a new application using the npx create react app command. I name my project as my React app. Since I want to create the app with TypeScript, I add the template TypeScript command. It will take a few seconds to create the project. Next, I navigate to the newly created React project. To use the Syncfusion React Tooltip component, I need to install the Syncfusion React popups package using the npm install. At syncfusion/ej2react-popups --save command. This command will install the React popups package along with its dependencies. The first thing I must do here is register the trial license key. So I open the index.tsx file and import the register license method from the syncfusion ej2 base package. To generate this trial key, refer to the link in the description below. Next, to add the tooltip component, I open the app.tsx file and remove the default code snippets. Then, import the React tooltip component from the React popups package. Here, I plan to display a tooltip when hovering over a button. To achieve this, I install the Syncfusion React button package using the npm install. At syncfusion/ej2react-buttons --save command. Next, import the button component from the Syncfusion React Buttons package and add it to the application. I set its content to show tooltip. To display a tooltip, add the tooltip component with the appropriate content to be displayed. I use the content property and set it to the desired text. Then, align the tooltip component by adding a few CSS styles, such as display, position, and left, using the style property. After that, I will define the CSS styles for the tooltip component. I open the app.css file and import the material theme CSS references. Finally, save the changes and run the application using the npm start command. You can see the button component with the text show tooltip, and when hovered over, it displays a tooltip. By default, the tooltip is placed at the top center of the target element. You can customize the position to 12 static locations like top left, top right, bottom left, and more. To change a position, set the position property to right center. See, the tooltip is displayed at the right center when I hover over the button. When moving away from the button, observe that the tooltip disappears. However, it can remain open by setting the isSticky property to true. See now, when hovering over the button, notice how the tooltip persists, even after moving away from the control. Suppose I want to close the tooltip, you can use the provided close button. So far, I have shown you how to render a tooltip with a simple string. Now let's explore how to render the tooltip content using an HTML template. I define an object named tooltip template. And within it, add a set of HTML elements. These elements include header, anchor, and image tags to display a heading, a website link, and an image within the tooltip. I then assign this tooltip template object to the content property and change the position to bottom center. In the app CSS file, I add CSS styles such as padding and float attributes to align these HTML elements. When I hover over the button, you can see the customized tooltip with the HTML content. In this video, I have shown you how to add the tooltip component to a React application. I have also shown you how to change its position, enable sticky mode, and render tooltip content using an HTML template. If you would like to see a working example of this, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also shared a link to learn about obtaining a free license key to use our React suite if you are eligible for our community license. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it helpful, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel.